In this problem, we want to compare two reactors that have different residence time distribution. And these are idealized residence time distribution paired to make calculations easy. We want to compare for a second order reaction, given a feed concentration of 2 moles per liter, which reactor is going to have the higher conversion. Now, these residence time distribution plots do not indicate the vertical scale, so part of the calculation is going to be determine the vertical scale. The main part of this calculation is that we're going to calculate the exit concentration from each of the reactors by integrating over all times of the residence time distribution and the concentration of A from a batch reactor. This is the solution of concentration as a function of time for a batch reactor. This is the normalized P of T plot, the residence time distribution. And what this assumes is segregated flow, as if we had a very large number of plug flow reactors in parallel, where you have different lengths corresponding to the different residence times. So first we need to normalize. And the way we're going to normalize is that the area under these curves is the total probability, which should be 1. And so I'm going to call this height H1. I'll call this height H2. And so H1 times the width here, which is 12 minus 8, that should equal 1. And likewise, H2 times the width, which is 18 minus 2, should also equal 1. So H1 is 1/4, and H2 is 1/16. So they're clearly on different scales. So let's look at now the first reactor. So I'll call this CA1 at the exit. We only need to integrate between 8 and 12 minutes because P of T is 0 everywhere else and P of T is 1/4 over this range. And now we need to put in the term from solution of batch reactor, second order reaction. So let's look at second order reaction, batch reactor, the change in the concentration in the reactor, if it's a constant volume reactor. It's a rate constant, concentration squared, so we can rearrange and separate variables and integrate. I've just put down the solution. It's fairly standard, where we separated variables, the limits of the inlet, namely CA0 and the outlet of the reactor for batch reactor, which means initial time and final time. And so the equation that we're going to use then, this is CA, and this term just means as a function of T. We're going to substitute that back into here, and then we're going to integrate this equation. So we're going to calculate the exit concentration from this first reactor. This is constant, CA0 is constant. Integration of this term denominator gives us a log term, and then we have to divide by this factor that's multiplying T inside that log term. And we're going to substitute the limits. Notice that the CA0 cancels here. And we can now substitute in the values. And then, of course, we have to substitute in the value for K, 0.3 liters per mole per minute, and the value for CA0, 2.0 moles per liter, so that KCA0 is 0.6 minutes to minus 1. And we end up with the exit concentration from the first reactor. Inlet concentration was 2, so we converted a significant amount. And we're going to do the exact same calculation to calculate CA2. And so what we have then is the exit concentration from the second reactor, and we can see that CA2 is larger than CA1, we have more reactant A leaving the second reactor. So that means less has been converted. So conversion for 2 is less than the conversion for 1. So reactor 1 has the higher conversion.